about all the PCOS symptoms and how can you manage it. Everybody with PCOS needs to solve for this. This is what makes losing weight really hard. Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm Aditi Guha, your weight loss coach, and in today's episode, we will be talking about all the PCOS symptoms and how can you manage it. So if you are someone who has been diagnosed with PCOS or had a history of PCOS, then this video is for you. So I'll start with a story. There were two friends, Neha and Sneha, and they both were very surprised to find that the other person had PCOS. And that's because they both looked and felt so different from one another. Neha, on one hand, was actually thin and she had been detected with excess testosterone, but all she was experiencing was a lot of hair fall. On the other hand, there was Sneha, who was just unable to lose weight. She almost felt like she would look at food and she would gain weight. And she was having crazy cravings, but she had no acne. So it's very natural that they both were surprised when they found that the other person had PCOS. And that's because, see, a Sneha, who has a more dominant androgen, like excess testosterone, while Sneha did not have that, but she had insulin resistance and inflammation. So what you need to understand about PCOS is that it is very multifaceted, and no two people actually have identical symptoms when it comes to PCOS. And in this video, I will take you through the different types and what could you do for each of them. So the first type of PCOS is called inflammation. And what it basically means is that our body has white blood cells, which are meant to protect us. But at some times they are produced in excess and they are just unable to differentiate between harmful and harmless things inside the body. So think about it like it's a soldier who is in the dark and suddenly feels there is a threat. So what he does is that he fires 100 bullets. Now, without understanding whether there is one enemy or 100 enemy. And that's exactly what is happening in inflammation. Inflammation is very central to PCOS. Pretty much everybody with PCOS needs to solve for this. What are the symptoms of inflammation? It would be cravings, feeling lethargy, having allergies or rashes, and it is something that requires a lot of elimination. So you need to figure out what kind of food or food items that are causing inflammation. And to do this, it's very important to take help, but you can actually control it to some extent by increasing consumption of anti-inflammatory food items like strawberries, almonds, a lot of vegetables, etc. The next type or the next symptom of PCOS is known as insulin resistance. A large majority of people with PCOS end up having insulin resistance, and this is what makes losing weight really hard. This can lead to craving for sugar and simple carbs, and this is something which can also affect your energy consistency. So you could have some energy crashes through the day. The best way to manage this is to make sure that every single meal has the four macros in it. That is protein, fat, carbs, and fiber. Now, thing is that a lot of people with PCOS have been told at some point or the other, lose the weight. And the truth is, if you don't address for this, you won't be able to lose the weight. And that is why PCOS can become so frustrating for so many women out there, because people make it out like you're lazy, you have no control over your food, when the truth of the matter is, if you have insulin resistance, it will be hard to control the cravings and it will be hard to lose the weight. So it's very important again to focus on correcting for this root cause as well as for inflammation. Now, if you are someone who has been diagnosed with PCOS or had a history of PCOS, nutrition will be very, very confusing. Doing caloric restriction or eliminating a particular macro will not give you any result. You may get some success with weight loss, but you will only gain it back and your cravings will be out of whack. So if you're someone who wants to nip it in the bud, what I would suggest is you definitely come and join my masterclass. Here I will be taking you through the three mistakes to avoid and what is my three-step framework that always works with PCOS or any kind of hormonal imbalance that a person might have. Now, the next symptom for PCOS is called adrenal fatigue, which is responsible for feeling of anxiety, mood swings, and to some extent, deprivation in sleep. So in this situation, what really happens is that when you wake up, you feel like you should go to bed. And when it is time to go to bed, you feel very awake. So this will lead to a lot of caffeine dependency. You will be deprived of sleep for a very long time. Now, what happens if you have adrenal fatigue? It does cause a little more excess androgen. It also affects your cravings, especially sugar craving. And it will, if unchecked over a period of time, can lead to burnout, even feeling of depression, PMS, mood swings, etc. So you see, a lot of things that a lot of women have been told is normal is actually not normal. These are hormonal imbalances and can be very much corrected. One thing that you must do if you find yourself having said yes to all these symptoms is definitely cut your caffeine intake. And for many people, it might help to switch from coffee to tea in this kind of situation. Now, this brings me to the next point, which is the excess of androgen. Some of the symptoms of this is hair fall or unwanted hair growth or acne around your jawline. This is something that requires that you take care of the inflammation and the insulin resistance along with some other stress mechanisms. So pretty much a lot of the three things that I have actually mentioned needs to be taken in care, and you will see a lot of improvement here. However, the physical signs of it takes the longest to go away. So if you are someone who is experiencing acne or chin beard, etc., it will take a long time for it to go away, but you will see a lot of the symptoms are under control. Now, apart from this, there are hormonal imbalances, which are just hormonal imbalance, which basically means the reproductive hormones like estrogen and your progesterone or testosterone are not talking to your pituitary gland, which is LH and FSH. When they are not in conversation with each other, sometimes you have other hormonal imbalances which can affect your period, which can affect conceiving. In some cases, again, insulin resistance and inflammation helps. But if you remember the example earlier, which I shared of Neha, who was really thin, in such cases, it basically means the hormonal imbalance is more than insulin resistance. And this is what leads to lean PCOS. In short, everybody with PCOS will not be gaining weight. There are thin people who have PCOS as well. In certain cases with PCOS, thyroidal symptoms are also there. There are women with PCOS who are also diagnosed with thyroid. This can even be an autoimmune, which is like Hashimoto's. And again, a lot of these symptoms can be managed when you have proper guidance of nutrition, lifestyle. But yes, this is something that adds to additional issues, and this, when addressed, can also help in reducing inflammation. But this is something that not all women with PCOS would have, but some of them would. In addition to this, most of the people generally have more than one of them, which basically means it's not that one person has only one of it. 95% women with PCOS actually have more than one. And therefore, the treatment of each needs to be very personalized. There is no one template that one has to follow. And the best way to actually solve for this is to get curious, is to become like a detective and note down your symptoms rather than being judgmental about it. Understand, PCOS is not a weight problem, it's not a lazy girl problem. It is a problem with a lot of symptoms, and once you solve for it, you solve for weight and feeling of lethargy as well. So while we wait for the next week's video, you can also check out my these videos, which has the hormonal imbalance signs and how hormones can impact your weight loss. And we will see you in the next video.